Welcome back for another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies like me, and I'm making this video with WPExplorer.com, the makers of the Total theme, and it's a totally awesome theme. And in this video, it's actually the second of a video series about AMP, which is Google's accelerated mobile pages. Now, in this video, I'm actually going to show you how to implement it on your WordPress website. Now, if you watched my first video, your head might have been spinning like, oh my goodness, this seems like it's going to be complicated. It's only going to be reserved for big publications. It sounded real complicated. Now, the good news is WordPress has you covered. There is a WordPress plugin I'm going to show you in this video. All you have to do is install and activate it, and you are AMP ready. That's it. And then there's a second plugin that will add more features to AMP. So AMP is going to really strip out a lot of what makes your website, right? So if you have things like advertisements all over it and related posts and all these kinds of sidebar widgets and all that, AMP is meant to kind of strip that down and just to your content to show that to people that are visiting your website on a mobile device. And so the AMP plugin that WordPress makes does that. But you're going to want to add some of those things back, like maybe some Google AdSense and some different features that you like. And so there's a plugin that's going to help add that back in. So why don't I stop talking and start showing you what I'm talking about? So this is the first plugin we're going to install. It's just AMP, and you can see it's being heavily used on WordPress websites right now, and that's because something that Google is really pushing on website owners to implement on their website. And then we're going to install this right here, AMP for WordPress, which is going to get us this list of features here that we're going to be able to add back into these AMP pages. You can see a couple of them here, related posts, recent comments, etc., etc., Google AdSense, things like that. So I'm in a WordPress installation here. All I have to do is go to Plugins, Add New, and then I'm going to just do a search for AMP right there. And the first result is, of course, going to be plugin made by the makers of WordPress. All you have to do is click on Install, and then we're going to go ahead and click on this Activate button. And that's pretty much all there is to having AMP on your website. Now, if you want to extend what actually shows on these AMP pages, that's when you're going to want to click on Add New again, and you're going to want to add that other plugin, and it's right here. It is right there, AMP for WP Accelerated Mobile Pages. So let's go ahead and click on Install on this one, and then we are going to click on Activate. Okay, now this plugin will have options, right? So we've got this new option panel here that says AMP, so we can go ahead and just click on that, and we have a variety of options that we can click through here to now have more control over what shows and how it shows on these AMP pages. And it's all pretty simple. You can go here and you can click through a lot of the different options to get it exactly how you want it. For example, advertisements, and we can have different ads that show on these AMP pages. And then here's options for the different single pages like post meta, featured images, pagination tags, and things like that, what you want to actually have showing on these pages that are being served up through AMP. And then you can also control your structured data, and you can have the ability to tweak some of the CSS settings. And what's nice is if you have lots of websites you are implementing this on, you can export your settings and then just import them on each of your websites. And it really couldn't be any easier than that. So this is what you need to do in order to implement AMP on your website. It is going to be a Google ranking factor at some point here soon, so you might as well start implementing it as soon as you can on your WordPress-based website. Hey, before you go, I have something for you. And before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video. And if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm gonna give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.